Hi there and welcome to the new Power BI tutorial. And in this tutorial I will show you how you can create a Gauss chart. So Gauss chart is very similar to, if you have seen the dashboard of the car, there you have the speed indicator or the heat indicator and maybe an indicator for the gasoline or the petrol or diesel. Then this is a very similar type of a chart which shows how far you have reached on the target or how far you are away from the target. So what I will show you how you can create this Gauss chart within Power BI and also format it for the relevant parameters. And before I do that, just a quick information that this sheet is present in the description. If you want to go and jump on to any tutorial or if you want to keep it like into your back pocket, just so that whenever you need it, you can actually go inside it, and the tutorial links are also present. So as and when they will be published, I will just add the tutorial links and you will be able to get it easily. All right, now let's go into the Power BI and see how we can create a Gauss chart. All right, so here we are within Power BI and we have the Gauss chart over here. So the Gauss chart is like this one, which I mentioned, sort of a dashboard that you have within your car. It's sort of a speedometer that is basically present in the form of Gauss. Now we need to add the couple of parameters, like what should be the value, what should be the minimum, what should be the maximum, target value, so on and so forth. So maybe we want to, let's say, understand the discounting, how we are giving the discount. So maybe what we can take is basically the discount. So right now what it is taking is the default numbers based on the discount field, and right now it is sum, but what I want is the average discount, which is the right indicator. So it's basically shows that 5% is basically the discount, and the highest value that you have is that the 0.10 or the 10%, right? And then what you can have is basically the slicer, just to understand the other categories. So for example, the slicer is present over here. And within that slicer, we can probably add the product category. And now once we select the product category, the information in this chart changes. So for office supplies or for technology. So right now, it does not show a lot of change because we have not configured the values over here, which we have to do that. So for example, the minimum value. So for discount, the minimum value, we will change it to the minimum. The maximum value, again, it will be the discount, and we will change it to the maximum. And what should be our target value? Now over here, we can again take the discount. However, from here, we need to basically choose. So for example, if I take the median, right? So the median is now coming over here, as where the median is present and where the average. So both are close to 0.05 because both are indicators of their average. However, if in your case you have a different field which contains targets, then you can actually put it over here as an aggregated field and it will start showing it over here. Now if I go to the this formatting, you have this Gauss axis. And right now nothing is being shown because we have configured everything over there. Then we have these data labels, and the data labels is nothing but these labels which are present over here. And even the data colors is present as the fill, and what is the target is sort of a blue. You can make it conditional colors as well. And over here in the general, we just wanted to show the X position and the Y position. Also, what I want to quickly show is, what if you don't have this minimum and maximum value? So if I just remove this, and even remove this, then I come over here and again come to the Gauss axis. Now the minimum, maximum and target value is generated. So let's say minimum value is 0, maximum value is, let's say, 0.20. So now if you see, the 0.20 is here, but and 0.05 is over here. And target is, let's say, 0.10. So we can see how far we are from the target, and then anything above the target is extra, or the extra bonus or the extra discount that you are giving, for which probably you may need approvals and everything. So with the help of this Gauss axis, if minimum, maximum and target value is not present here, then only these three fields will be enabled, otherwise not. But that's about how you can configure the settings or how you can configure the values within the cost chart. Also, down there, if you see, there is a target. It's about the formatting of the target, and then a couple of more formatting options, which is pretty regular when you have the other chart. So I'm not putting it over here. But that's very quickly about how you can create a speedometer and sometimes even used it as a KPI. So, you know, you can have like multiple charts where you have reached the sales as compared to the target. What is your profit target? What is your discount target? You can show it at the top and then basically show the KPIs and then related information into the respective charts. So also it is used as the KPI chart. But that's about it. And I'll meet you in the next topic.